Psalms chapter 28, I'm moving. David has been asked to fight with the Philistines against his own people. Lord, have mercy. Once again, he used his mind before he used his fist. He didn't really want to do it because he was loyal to God. The Lord allowed something to work out. They didn't have to worry about it. The people said, hey, what they doing here? Oh, he's with me. He been here a whole year, never read y'all word. He been here a whole year. He ain't did nothing. He good with me. He ain't trying to kill us. He ain't snuck at night and trying to stab us. He been here a whole year. We good. They said, He done killed, they went back to his child, they said he done killed the lion. Can you imagine that? I heard what he was saying when he killed the lion. He said he would defy the armies of God, and certainly he ain't changed, and I don't trust him. And so he didn't even have to worry about fighting. The princess said, no, you can't go with us. He had to leave. See how God would do that? Some of y'all don't know how you're going to do this between a rock and a hard place. But I promise you, when you are loyal to the Lord, and when you are a studier of His Word, and when you speak His Word, some things you ain't going to have to fight. Tell the devil that's what's going on this season. Some things I ain't going to have to fight. All I got to do is quote this Word and believe God and stay in Him, and He's going to fight. He's going to do it. He's going to do it. All right? Chapter 30. So David got up in the morning, he left. Him and his men. Chapter 30 is where I'm going to come from, but I'm going to talk about some real life stuff first. And we're going to dance. I'm almost done. Amen. 2012, my cousin Apostle Jenkins, for 4 days, this little skinny boy right over here, went to Philadelphia with me and nursed me all back to health. God is good. That's why the Lord is going to bless him. We're not going to talk about that right now. But I want to go hard, so I applied for a job in D.C. And went to work a week after my surgery. I had to relocate to Newark, Delaware, and stay with my sister. I had an old van that would work one day and didn't work the next day, so I had to use Delaney's police car he had. Remember that John Brown police car? I used to get up 3:30 a.m. to drive 45 minutes to catch the train by 4:45 a.m. in Perrysville, to get to New Carlton by 6:15, then get on the Orange Line to go to the 27th Street bus stop to catch a bus to be my job by 7:30 a.m. I opened up and left by 3 to get to Perrysville by 6 and get home by 6:45 at my sister's, and then the next day repeated every Monday through Friday. That was my schedule. Lord help us. Finally, I had collected enough money to buy a little Equinox from a second chance dealer. Y'all know what they are. Your credit, you lose about 5 cars, they're going to give you a car, right? You'll pay $900, but they still give you a car. Amen. So then I moved out of my sister's after a year and 2 months, and I moved to Elkton. I had one of the workers tell me they wanted me to get a more efficient car that would help me with better gas mileage. So I found a little Toyota Corolla that had 33,000 miles, but my credit score required me to get a cosign. The member came to the car dealer and said, did you get it yet? I said, no. They said, why? I signed the cosign. They said, well, you're not leaving here without that car. So he cosigned. I put $500 down. Here, my little white car, I named her Angel. Praise the Lord. I then was promoted on my job and moved back to Baltimore office. Now, between 2012 and 2013, the Berkeley E. Roach High School that y'all went to see December 14th had 4 students that graduated. All together. From 2 years, they had 4 students that graduated. I'm talking about what God can do. Y'all don't hear me. Because I didn't know about the Marketplace Ministry. By June of 2013, the Lord told me to leave that job and focus on your ministry. I already knew the struggle that was about to take place. Because in my mind, the church's tithes will once again make me in poverty. They're going to have me lose everything. Because that's what I thought I had to do.
Come on,
I was thinking like a priest and not a king.
My God.
Look at somebody and say, Lord, help me to think like a king.
Help me.
I don't see it. Nobody ever told me, but help me to think like a king. Lord, have mercy. Oh, boy.
Come on, you're talking good.
I lost my apartment, and I stayed with my daughter, Nika. I would go to my cousins, and I would stay at Chris's. At one point, I would wake up and have to figure out where I was at because I didn't have a stable place to live. I would wake up in the morning, where am I at? Because I didn't have a stable place to live. I didn't know where I was at. Oh, I'm at Nika's. Oh, I'm at Chris's.
Come on.
Come on, yes, sir. 1,520 per month. Somebody say failure. That I've received. Somebody say failure. 2014, Pastor Sonia Harris asked me to develop something that would help the local and national churches with my school concept. I told her I would think about it. After I told her let's do it, she had me on an interview on the internet radio. It was endorsed by Prophet Chambers, a nationally syndicated program. In 2013, y'all better hear me.
Come on,
Jesus. In 2013 of December, at an apostle's birthday service, I was told to focus on my living and not the ministry. I needed to back up from the ministry. It's time for you to live. And saints pray for the apostle's life and not his ministry. Y'all remember that? Bless his heart. I remember feeling like they just want me gone because I'm going to get on everybody every day. I remember having a conversation with my oldest son. He just said that I had ministry down pat. But I've missed my life because I've had ministry in every area of my life. And he brought up a story about a Mercedes, because he was like, remember stuff, how he's like, mayor, and I feel about it. He said, Dad, you won a Mercedes one time. You went to Mercedes and looked at it, and you just never did nothing about it. That ain't going to happen in 2016.
Come on.
Huh? I'm going to have a Mercedes.
Right.
I already got it in the works. Don't y'all think I'm lying? Yeah, I already got it. That's what I already had it, praise the Lord. 2014, February, the first Power Party and Ministry graduation happened. It was 11 students